I'm here with the heavyweight champ of the world, you gotta say Bonds, Bond and Wilder. How you feeling today?
Man, I'm feeling wonderful. I'm feeling amazing. And man, we just got great positive energy right here, great spirit, man. And we just got finished sparring, had a long round of sparring, and shit, it's over with. My body is killing me right now, but we got through it.
And you coming down in camp, your fight is coming up, man. Talk to us a little bit about your preparations and fight week, you know.
Yeah, man, it's been good. You know, I've had a lot of guys like all over the world come here. You know what I mean? It's a blessing to be able to have the finance to bring these guys here all over the world. I remember at one point in time where we had no money. You know, we couldn't bring fighters here. We couldn't get the best of sparring. What I had to do, I had to use what I had in the gym. I mean, whether it was from little kids on up to like amateurs, you know what I mean? We had little to none heavyweights. And we just had to do what we had to do. I remember times we had to scrape up money, go to Atlanta and get some sparring. Man. You know what I mean? So, man, God is good, man. The universe is amazing, and it's working in my favor.
And man, you're normally a humble person, man. It seems like this camp of Breazeale got a little animal out of your, yeah, you, your bossy, man. What, can you talk to us a little bit about what brought that aside out of you?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I blessed Breazeale to be on my card in Birmingham, and he got carried away. I understand that because I was fighting, it's just too much, you know. But basically he came here to Birmingham, he started some chaos, you
should know, he said, more respectful.
You feel me? He said some things that he shouldn't have said. And he don't want a man up to it, you know what I mean? I'm a man, so whatever my wrongdoings, I can accept my wrongdoings with open arms. You know, what I can't tolerate is a man to start something, especially in somewhere else city, and not man up to it. And it got out of line, you know what I mean? This could have been squashed at the arena, but he knew I wanted him, but he chose to go to the hotel. So, you in my city, I was gonna find you either way. You know, Breazeale could have lost his life that night. And I want to iterate on that. I keep saying it because it's real life. It's true story. He could have lost his life that night. I had guys apologizing to me because they didn't get at him. They couldn't get to him. You know, they got escorted out of the hotel because they had weapons on them and stuff like that. You know what I mean? But, you know, the best thing about boxing is that whatever we have, our differences outside of the ring, we can settle it. We can handle it inside of the ring. You know what I mean? And get paid for it. That's the beauty part of it. So what goes around comes around in this situation. And, you know, I needed this motivation. I needed this push at this moment in time in my career. You know what I mean? Being a champion, you know, I've gotten away and I get away with a lot of things with my style, you know, with my height, you know, with my power. And, you know, at this point in time, I got the world attention. Just like I wanted, and it's been amazing. You know, just the scenery, when I walk places, where I go places now, you know, just everything about being the heavyweight champion of the world is coming together. People are loving it. And to this day, you know what I mean? That been crazy, you know what I mean? And I'm just loving it. And at this point in time, I feel like, hey, let's break it down to the basics. People want to see Deontay box like he did against Berman Severn 1. That was easy. Now the popularity has risen. More people is involved in boxing. Now we got the casual fan that's interested. Let's show them what I can do when I'm disciplined in the ring. And this is what it's been all about, just breaking things back down, you know, investing in myself. I've invested in myself like crazy this year, like none other. And, you know, I needed this motivation all because of Dominique Brazil. So I want to thank him for that. You know, and I'm looking forward to May 18th.